Na 10 dae is ons nou op 'n stadium wat dit nie meer voel soos 'n vakansie nie en realiteit dalk begin inskop. Dit is tyd om weer te begin fokus op akademie en voorbereiding vir kwartaal 2. We are in the midst of an epidemic focused on physical health and illness, but we can by no means ignore our mental health during this time. Feelings of worry and anxiety are quite normal to experience. We must remember that anxiety is our body's normal response to stress. It's the fear about what is to come and what is to happen. And in a time where we have so many things that are uncertain, anxiety and stress are prone to rise. You might not even know that you are experiencing stress or anxiety during this time, and it can come in different forms. Ons graad 12 leerders is dalk bekommerd oor aansoeke tot universiteit en die eindeksamen, of ons graad 11 leerders oor punte wat hulle gaan moet kan oplewer vir volgende jaar se aansoeke. There's various things that might be causing stress at this stage. So today I would like to speak to you about 6 tips on coping with lockdown and coping during this time. I want to speak about routine, physical health, social interaction, screen time, monitoring your thoughts, and lastly, having a healthy outlook. Eerste is vaste routine vir my ongelooflik belangrik. Jy kort 'n vaste daaglikse routine, wat beteken jy staan op 'n sekere tyd, jy maak jou bed op, jy trek aan en jy weet wat jy vandag gaan doen, wanneer jou tyd vir akademie gaan wees, wanneer dit vir oefen, sosiale interaksie gaan wees en jy beplan jou dag. My vaste routine sluit ek slaap in, want ek weet ons manne is beteken baie lief daarvoor om heel dag te lê en slaap en in die bed te bly en dit is nie 'n goeie ding nie. Binnekort is jy terug in die skoolstelsel en ek wil nie hê dat jy moet sukkel om weer gewoon te raak aan 'n normale routine nie. Secondly, physical health. You need exercise during this time. Daily exercise. There's a variety of videos that's been uploaded to the PRG website that can help you with this. If you know that you are not in a state of wanting to exercise alone or doing your exercise alone, join chat groups, go on Skype with your friends and do exercise together. And also try and eat as healthy as possible, because this can also affect your mood. Sosiale interaksie is belangrik. Dit moet 'n ongelooflike aanpassing vir elke liewe een van julle wees om nie jou vriende elke dag te sien nie, om nie met jou maats sport te kan doen nie. So jy moet 'n plan maak.